Separately, Madam President, shortly the Senate will pass another important piece of legislation, the Adam Walsh Reauthorization Act. This is legislation that will better equip the states to track sex offenders and prevent abuse. Since the new majority took control of this chamber, the Senate has prioritized bills that protect victims, that make our community safer, and this latest bill fits that model. For example, I was proud to introduce the Justice for Victims of Trafficking Act, which was signed into law by President Obama this last spring. That happened to enjoy a 99-0 vote here in the Senate. Clearly, bipartisan legislation directed at helping the victims of human trafficking. This law, I'm glad to report, has already begun helping those victims recover and find a path for healing. And then in another example, the Senate Judiciary Committee recently approved the Justice for All Reauthorization Act, legislation I introduced with our colleague from Vermont, Senator Leahy, that will improve the criminal justice system by helping eliminate the backlog of untested rape kits in communities throughout the country and by helping victims find justice faster. I might add that thanks to the leadership of Chairman Grassley and the Senate Judiciary Committee, the Judiciary Committee has been as active and as productive as any other time that I've been in the Senate. And finally, earlier this year, we joined several of our colleagues to introduce Carey's Law, another bipartisan bill that would ensure that people have the ability to directly call 911 without having to dial an extra number. This happened to be particularly important in hotel rooms and other places where, particularly if a young child picks up a phone and dials 911 like they've been instructed, that they be able to get through. This is a simple change, but one that will help law enforcement and emergency personnel reach those that need help as soon as possible. And I hope we can move this legislation forward soon as well. So, Madam President, I'm proud of the work that the Senate has done in these and other areas this year, and I hope this afternoon we can add the Adam Walsh Reauthorization Act to that list.